Why LR parsing? LR parsing is most general non-backtracking shift reduced parsing, yet it is still efficient. So what is the good thing in LR parsing is that it is not, not a backtracking purpose. Okay, it means in the previous parsing techniques, when we have gone through like top-down parsings, we had to do some backtracking, right? But here backtracking is, you can say avoided, or we don't need to backtrack. We can simply detect an error without doing try and error things or backtracking. Okay, once you encounter the error, run error, it is going to declare that this parse is not going to be successful. Okay, so this is the good thing here. Okay, it saves our time, and shift reduce parsing. What happened? Shift reduced parsing, yet so this is also called shift reduced parsing. We have already discussed this, and yet it is still efficient, right? So the clash of grammars that can be presented using LR method is a proper subset of the clash of grammar that can be parsed with predictive parses. Predictive parsing we have already discussed in our previous discussion, right? So we can simply say that LL1 grammars are proper subset of LR1 grammars. Okay. Now an LR parser can detect a syntactic error as soon as possible, or as soon as it is possible to do so, and left to right scan of the input. So we already know that this LR parsers does left to right parsing, or left to right scanning of the input symbols, right? So this is there. So here you can see the most powerful shift reduce parsing is LR parsing, where L stands for left to right scanning of the input, R stands for rightmost derivation of the input, and this K is for K look ahead. When we parse tree, or when we try to construct parse tree for a given string, like say ID multiplication ID, and when we construct the parse tree arbitrarily, okay, we basically predict that which rule we have to apply at what node, so that we can produce this given input string, right? So how we predict? We predict that rule basically looking at this input symbols, okay? And your brain will work more sharper based on how many input string, or how many input symbols from the input string you can see, and you can just analyze that what can be the possible production rule which will lead you to this particular string, correct? So it happens. So the same concept used in LR parsing by using the look ahead. So see, when it is pen and paper written thing, and we are by human being, it is happening on pen and paper, we can look at the whole string at a time. But for a computer, you have to define that how many input string does the computer look at a time, and does the compiler look at a time, and do the analysis. Now, if you think, if you allow the system or the compiler to read or to look one symbol ahead, okay, one symbol ahead, what symbol is coming, okay, then your analysis, that logic you develop, is going to be quite simple, because it is only one handling one symbol ahead. But if you think about two symbols at a time it can see, then it, you have to do more analysis, right? Now, so for our simplicity, we are only going for k equal to 0 and k equal to 1. That means in when k equal to 0, it is simply going to be called as LR parsing, and when k equal to 1, it is going to be called as LR 1 parsing. Understand? So, first, what we will see? We will see LR 0 parsing. Okay, or we also call this as SLR parsing or simple LR parsing. Okay, so here are some things about LR parsers. It covers wide range of grammars. This is the good thing about it. And I have already told you, SLR means simple LR parser. LR is most general LR parser. Okay. And there is another thing called LALR parser. That means intermediate LR parser or look ahead LR parser. So LALR in full form is look ahead LR parser. Okay. So what is the good thing? So here we are finding that we are speaking about three parsing technique. You know, all of them are basically bottom up parsing technique, or you can say LR parsing technique, right? And what are these? We're finding that there are SLR parsing, LR parsing, and LALR parsing. Four kind of parsing technique we are looking at this. Now, good thing here is that the parsing algorithm, okay, parsing algorithm are same for all these three types of parsing technique. Okay, now what is different? Different is the parse table, or construction of the parse table. Okay, construction of the parse table is the only difference, the way of constructing it. Okay, so you can see here, their parsing tables are different. So for a given grammar G, you can have SLR parser as well as you may have LR, you may have LLR parser. But thing is that there are few grammars which may not be supported by all these three grammars. Okay, all these three parsing techniques. There are few grammars which will be only possible to use LLR parsing technique. There are some grammar which can be supported by SLR but not LLR, like that the relation is there. We will understand that when we will know that how things are working and why some grammar may not be supported by SLR or some other parsing technique. Okay, that only can be understood when we'll know the parsing techniques of different LR parsing technique. So the model of an LR parser looks like this. You can see the LR parsing program is there. So this parsing program algorithm are almost same for SLR or LR1 or LALR parser. Okay. Now it will have a stack. Okay, in the stack it will maintain the current state, you can say. Okay, And it will have a parse table also. Okay, and we will find that this parse table have basically two part. One part is called action, another part is called go to. Okay, and there definitely are input tape. Somewhere that LR parser will read the tokens. Okay, here basically A1, it you know up to AN, all these are what tokens. Okay, so all these are tokens. Now constructing SLR parsing.